So 60 to 80% of newborns will have jaundice, and you know, not all of it needs treatment. There are different kinds of jaundice. There's a type of jaundice where your liver is affected. Most newborns don't have that. Jaundice is the yellow discoloration of the skin, basically. And the kind of jaundice the newborns have is because they break down their newborn red cells and they form adult cells. And the byproduct of that makes the baby have yellow skin color.
Jaundice is a symptom. It's not a disease as such, but it's a symptom as a result of many liver conditions. We call a patient is having jaundice when the patient gets yellow eyes, or the skin gets yellow, or the urine changes into yellow in color, and patient might be getting itching and feel generally very, very unwell. So what exactly the cause of the jaundice? As I said, jaundice is a symptom but not a disease. And jaundice is because of liver infections such as hepatitis B, hepatitis C, hepatitis A or hepatitis E. Or sometimes patient taking excess alcohol intake, that can also cause jaundice. And there are lots of other varieties of causes of jaundice. For example, a gallbladder stone which slips into the common bile duct, which is a bile pipe, can cause obstructive jaundice. And similarly, a pancreatic mass, a cancer affecting the pancreas, can block the common bile duct, that can also produce jaundice. In addition to all this, a cancer somewhere else, for example, a colon cancer, a large intestinal cancer or stomach cancer, can spread into the liver, and because of the cancer spread, that also can be a cause of jaundice. How do you prevent jaundice? Some of the jaundice can be prevented. For example, if the jaundice is caused by hepatitis A and hepatitis E, by sticking to healthy and pure water can prevent jaundice. But if the jaundice is because of gallbladder stones or cancer, there is nothing much can be done to prevent jaundice. So, but whatever in our hands, such as sticking to hygienic practices, hand washing techniques, consuming pure and healthy water and food, can prevent infective jaundice. The treatment of jaundice depends on what exactly the cause of jaundice. For example, if someone gets viral infection such as hepatitis A or hepatitis E, the treatment can be just a supportive treatment. For example, IV hydration, multivitamins, taking less of an oil food, all this can be a supportive treatment when the liver tries to regenerate itself. But if the jaundice is because of a stone blocking the bile pipe, we need to remove the stone by doing a procedure called ERCP, where we pass a camera into the stomach and duodenum and enter the bile duct, cut open the bile duct and remove the stone. Sometimes jaundice could be because of a cancer, a pancreatic cancer causing bile duct blockage, that can be relieved by ERCP and putting a metal stent. Sometimes giving liver support medication can help liver to regenerate more cells, can get rid of jaundice. But taking herbal medication and taking local medication can be extremely dangerous treatment for jaundice.
Plenty of liquids helps the body flush out the toxins as well as replenish the potassium that's lost due to vomiting. Drink coconut water, barley water, clear soups, buttermilk, thin broths, skim milk, sugarcane juice, wheatgrass juice, and other fruit and vegetable juices. Consume carbohydrate-rich foods to restore the energy levels in the body. For this, include breads, oats, rice, potatoes, honey, and jams in your diet. It's essential to have fresh vegetables that contain vitamins, minerals, and antioxidants, as these help in liver recovery. Eat carrots, beetroots, tomatoes, bell pepper, and French beans. Make sure to eat fruits rich in vitamin C, as these aid in liver cell regeneration. Consume fare like oranges, guavas, Indian gooseberries, and kiwis.